Glad you could join us. Agriculture Cabinet Secretary Mwangi Kiunjuri is currently appearing before the National Assembly's Agriculture Committee, trying to give answers on the National Cereals and Produce Board scandal. Let's just cross over there live and listen in.
The big fish, or those who are hiding behind these big
traders,
can only be established after EACC and other investigative arm of the government establishes who, for example, this Celestine Chepchir, whether indeed she is the trader or there are groups of traders who are fronting her. So that can only come after the investigation is done, right?
The CS has said the government has not imported maize from Uganda or elsewhere. But what has caused this a lot of maize suddenly which has gone to the cereals board? Can we also get a report from the borders whether there was a traders brought in maize? Yes, in your investigation, in the 3 weeks you are going to report to us, could you give us, because even this morning I said in the paper, there's a lot of maize flooding in Busia, in Malaba. It's coming free.
Okay, you have made your point, Honorable Member. Yes.
The good actions he has taken, what happens now to those farmers who have not been paid?
Okay. And one question from...
Yes. Thank you. Thank you, Chairman. My name is Honorable Caleb Kositany, MP for Soy. I came in late, and the question I wanted to ask, seek clarity from the Minister. Going forward, we have been given 21 days in order to bring up a conclusive investigative report. But the main concern of our farmers, the people we represent, is payment for those who have already delivered their maize into the cereals board and those who still have maize in their stores and are waiting to deliver the cereals board. We want now an answer from you. When will these farmers be paid? And when will you reopen the stores for the other farmers to deliver their maize? Secondly, as a point of clarification to the minister, I've heard him say twice that we are defending traders and who is defending the common farmer. We come from a region whereby we've been growing maize all our lives. Those people who you claimed are cartels, or those, the list that you gave, are people who have been trading in maize since we were born. There are people who have grown year in, year out, saving the small farmer who cannot queue in the line with 50 bags, 5 bags, 10 bags. So these traders also represent a whole group of small-scale farmers. And I think, as a representative of the people, we want to know who delivered the major maize that went into the cereals board in Transmara. Who delivered maize into Bungoma silos? Who delivered maize to fill the silos in Kakamega? I spoke to somebody from Webuye the other day, and he was telling me that they went to sleep one evening, and there was no queue at the Webuye cereals board. But when they woke up in the morning, there was a line of about 3 kilometers. Lorries just came in at night, and they were not small. No farmer, very few farmers, can deliver maize in the 20-ton lorries that we see, that we saw, they saw in the queue. Okay, so it raises questions.
Thank you. So,
yeah, Chair,
Dr. Mutunga? What is it?
In those 21 days, Chair, we are looking at a future and Big Four and delivering food security. And we can only deliver food security if we are able to increase production and productivity around our farmers. We may not have food security through importation and through dubious, trending of maize. So what is the ministry's strategy to make sure that such things do not recur in future? Because I asked a question, what will be new and different from the registration of farmers, which they have not taken into account right now at the vetting level. Chair, there's another issue which I want to follow up. It's still on maize and it's still on NCPB. Chair, about six years ago, the stores in the eastern region were closed, NCPB, because there was an outbreak of aflatoxin. People in that region eat maize from their farms. Chair, I would like to know, if it was aflatoxin, does it mean that those people are condemned to aflatoxin? Why are the stores not open up to now?
Okay, thank you. Thank you, members. I just want us to allow Honorable CS to make his submissions. I know we are politicians. We would like to vent.
But Chairman, as he makes his submission, he should make a long statement. What I want to say.
Finally, I'll give you. But please allow, if we just talk some amongst ourselves and we don't get submission from the CS, that we are not doing a service to the subject. So please, much as we would now ask those questions, then we must have a stop to those questions and allow the CS and his team and any other member who wants to also compliment the CS to be able to give us information. Let's gather as much information as we can. Honorable Ouda, and finally,
To me, I think I won't have this chance again. I'm just putting up my observation. Looking at this issue, Chairman, you know, as much as the CS came in January, I think 27th, as he says, the reason why we are having all these problems is because you don't have coordination. As much as we are in Parliament doing oversight and he's in the executive, you should have been working hand in hand because some of these things are just common sense. For example, a farmer delivering over 200 bags. And these members of Parliament, some of us have information. You could have volunteered. But you are working like a one-stop shop alone. But a CS going forward, and this is what I have to tell you because I won't have this chance again. You should not work as a one-stop shop. Otherwise, we'll ask why all this multi-practice took place under your watch. Then you should not even be talking about the CEOs resigning or whoever is resigning. Should have been the one resigning, and your PS should have been the one stepping aside. And because you work alone when a CS, I really ask myself sometimes if you really have the plight of farmers in your mind and in your heart. Sometimes I ask myself if you really have farmers from your place. Me personally, I may not be a farmer, but I'm a Kenyan citizen born in this country. We have to be serious with this issue. You have to take issue. And the issue of talking about even 21 days, but a chairman, to me, action must be taken and there must be big fish. Otherwise, it's the CS then who should step aside over this issue. And let's not talk about the CEOs and the depot managers.
Thank you. Thank you. Those are your sentiments.
Yeah, Chair.
My son?
Yeah, Chair. Yangu chair, nafikiri chair tumekubaliana 21 days, waenda wafanya investigation yao vizuri na tulete chair. Ni muhimu sana minister.